Yes, this is just like a Norman Rockwell painting. Mom is serving breakfast, Daddy is reading the newspaper, and Brother Eric is trying to hide a big, purple, nasty hickey.
Hickey? I don't have a hickey.
You know, Eric, hickeys lead to dirty things.
For God's sakes, don't let Donna suck your neck. She's a nice girl.
I don't have a hickey. I was using a curling iron.
Oh, well, will you just look at that?
Oh, Mom!
Brad, remember that time?
No, and neither do you.
Okay. Laurie, what's on the agenda today?
Agenda?
A list of goals or actions one might feel good about achieving so as to... Eric, you tell her.
Mom, come on, relax. I'm still getting used to being back home.
Yeah, flunking out of college can be draining.
Phew.
Eric!
Oh, come on, that was so mild.
Well, Laurie, all you do is sit around the house and watch television. You should come down to the hospital and volunteer.
She's right, Laurie.
Daddy! You know, I think Eric needs an agenda. Look at his neck.
It's a birthmark. It's been there since birth.
Good morning, class.
Well, good morning, orphan.
Good morning.
That's all you got?
Oh. Whore.
Yeah. Stephen, honey, you are too young for coffee. Have some juice.
Mrs. Foreman, I need coffee. Your son kept me up all night bragging about his hickey.
Give me the remote control.
Give me a reason why I shouldn't set you on fire.
All right, Laurie, take your best shot.
Oh, Rad, we talked about this. Let him go.
Hello, Laurie. I apologize for coming unannounced, but I...
Mom, Daddy, this is Professor Stark. He was my art history teacher.
Well, actually, I was your psychology teacher.
Well, whatever you taught her, she flunked it.
Eric... So, you're from the University of Wisconsin. Yeah. Are you here to give me back my money?
Well, actually, I came here because of Laurie.
Oh, yes. He came to see if the university would take me back.
Really? Oh, please. Here, have a seat. I'll make coffee and cake. I'll make coffee cake and coffee. Oh, gosh. Really, can you get her back into the university and out of my house?
Well, I'm going to try my darndest.
Well, this is really good news.
This is the best news I've ever heard.
Yes, it is. I want to get Laurie back in school.
Professor, question. How lame exactly is your student body if you're trying to get this dumb cat back?
Eric! Don't be a smart mouth. We've got company.
Yeah, yeah, go make coffee. Don't scare him off. He's our only hope. So, maybe you could stay for dinner.
Why, yes, thank you. That would be lovely. Oh, and I believe these paint chips are yours.
Well, these are the color of our front door, aren't they?
Yeah. You had a paint chip hanging from your front door, so I started to peel it, and I guess I got a little overzealous.
Psychology, huh?
Yes, yes. Human foibles fascinate me.
This news about Laurie leaving, it's just a little ray of sunshine.
Well, I just wish that more teachers cared about their students like you do. I think it all started going downhill when you couldn't paddle the kids anymore.
Pansy-ass Supreme Court.
Shut up.
Hey, Foreman, he who hesitates is boned.
Laurie is one of the most gifted young women in my class. I've always enjoyed having her.
I own you.
Is there something wrong with the bread?
No, why?
Oh, Laurie. I know something that you don't know that I know, you know?
Yes, yes. Tell us, Foreman, so that we can all know.
You don't know anything. And if you do know something, I will make you sorry you were ever born.
Well, for your information, I'm already sorry I was ever born. Eric, see?
So, what does she need to do to get back into school?
Well, she'll have to work with me. Make a commitment to school. She'll really have to buckle down.
Well, what do you think, Laurie? Are you willing to give it a go?
Oh, Mother, she's very willing. You know, Dad, I just saw the most interesting thing today in the garage.
Burst into flames! Burst into flames! Burst into flames!
It was just... it was so surprising.
Oh, Eric, do tell.
I saw Laurie.
I'm in love with your daughter. Dad.
Dad! Come here!
So I guess I disappointed you, Daddy. I'm really sorry. I just wish he wouldn't have taken advantage of me and my love for education.
That is just so weak.
Well, I guess you're not the first student to be taken advantage of by a teacher.
Oh, wait, where are you going with that, Dad?
Just try not to be too hard on yourself.
No, no, no!
And the really sad thing is, Eric saw him kiss me today, and he didn't even try to stop it.
Because she wanted it.
You knew about this and you didn't do anything? She's your sister.
Yeah, Eric. Why?
I'll deal with you later, Eric. Come on, Laurie. I'll make you a cup of coffee and explain to you the nature of men. Something I thought you already knew, but apparently you don't.
Eric, I forgive you.
Well, this is unforgivable. In fact, you suck. I'll be in my room.
Oh, Mom. Oh, my God, Mom. I had her in my sights. I mean, she was right in the crosshairs.
Oh, honey, you know I love you and your sister equally. But if you ever get an opportunity again, for God's sake, pull the trigger.